Hey guys, this is Ebonee and I decided I'm going to do more face of the day videos on my channel because they're quick and easy to do and they're not like a makeup tutorial that takes time to film and edit and all of that. It's just quick and easy, so I decided why not. I'll go ahead and do more face of the day videos because I'm always experimenting and trying new things with my makeup, and definitely I think it would be fun to share. So today for this makeup look, I'm going to show you the products that I use. For my foundation, today I used Estee Lauder's Double Wear Foundation in Rich Cocoa. This color, I've been really loving this foundation ever since I purchased it. It's really good. And then to set my foundation, I used an Oldie. And this is MAC's Mineralize Skinfinish in Deep Dark. I haven't used this powder in months, but I decided to go ahead and use it today. And for those of you who are not aware, this is more like a sheer coverage. It doesn't give you like a full coverage like maybe MAC Studio Fix Powder or like some of the other powders that you may use. This is more of like a sheer coverage. But I really like it because it can give the face like a really pretty glow, if you can kind of see what I got going on here. Like, I didn't highlight my forehead or anything like that, but I just sprinkled I just brushed a little bit of this powder over my face, and my face has this really nice glow going on. So I like that. For my cheeks, I used this particular blush that I've showed you guys many times before, and this is Cargo Cosmetics Laguna blush. It looks kind of pale in the pan, but once I put it on my cheeks, it gives me this rich warm orange color. And then to highlight my cheeks, I used MAC's Soft and Gentle. And let me swatch this for you guys. I don't know how I feel about this one. I've had it a while, but I rarely use it. That's the color right there. It's very pretty, but it has really chunky glitter in it. You probably can see it in the pan and all over the perimeter of the pan. It has like really chunky glitter. So I guess you really got to be careful with this. Maybe during the day, at night, I think it would look really pretty, but during the day, I would just use a light hand because the glitter is chunky. So for my eyes, I used one of my MAC palettes, and this one has mainly pinks and purples and a little bit of orangey type colors. And for my lid, I used this color right here, and this is called Paradisco. It's a pinkish gold color. Okay, swatch right there. I don't really care for that color because if you can't tell, it kind of comes off a little bit ashy on my skin. And whereas I wanted more of this pink color, it didn't show up like that on my lids. The look still turned out pretty in my opinion, but I wasn't going for this color on the lids. And then for my crease, I used this color right here, which is Shadowy Lady, and it's a matte purple color, and I really like this color because the pigmentation is not intense. And I know every time people purchase eyeshadows, they always want eyeshadows that are very pigmented, but for me, I can appreciate some eyeshadows that are not very pigmented because you can build up the intensity to what you wanted, and you won't take like a little bit of eyeshadow, put it on your eye, and next thing you know, you done messed up your whole eye look because the pigmentation is too intense. Like, I like some eyeshadows, like this Shadowy Lady. I swatched it one time, and look, you can barely see it. Let me see if I can swatch it again. So this is what it looks like on my finger, and this is what it looks like swatched. So as you can see, that the pigmentation is not great, but it makes for a gorgeous crease color because it's pale enough. The intensity is pale enough, I don't know how to describe it, where I can blend it out and get a nice wash of purple, but not like an intense amount of purple in my crease. So I really like that color, I really do. This nice warm orangey color that you see right above my crease, it's actually MAC's Rule, and that's this orange color right here. And I just put that right above Shadowy Lady to kind of warm it up and give a nice warm transition right there. So that's the color I use in my transition area. To line my top lid here, and then to fill in my waterline here, I used a Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Pencil in the color Delinquent, and it's a deep, deep purple with sparkle. It's a very pretty color. I love this pencil. And let's see, on my lips, I used NYX Lip Pencil in the color Prune, and that's the color right there. It's not very pigmented, but definitely it gives me the look I'm going for. So I put it just like this in the on the perimeter of my lips like I normally do. And then I filled in my lips with this MAC lipstick. It's a matte color and the color's Pink Plaid, one of my favorites. And that's the color right there. Let me swatch it for you. That's Pink Plaid. It's a pale pink color, matte finish. And I really wasn't going for a matte look today, so I topped it with this lip gloss, also from MAC. I used a lot of MAC products in my look today. I didn't realize that until I'm making this video. But I use a lot of MAC products to create this look. So this look, this lip gloss is called Playful Petal. Let me swatch that. This is such a pretty color. It's like pink, but it has like purple sparkle in it. It's right here. I put that on top. So those were my lips. What am I forgetting? Oh, my eyebrows. So for my eyebrows, I use an oldie but goodie. This is an eyebrow pencil that I used to use all the time in high school. And then as I started getting better with makeup, I decided, oh, I needed like an eyebrow kit, or I needed this particular eyebrow mousse or this particular eyebrow gel or whatever. And when I think about it, what I used in high school is pretty much all I need. Like sometimes the older products that you use that worked well, it's all you need. So I use this Maybelline Expert Warrior pencil in dark brown. Just a dark brown pencil. I used it to fill in my eyebrows. I did not use any concealer. I did not use anything else, just this pencil, and it worked just fine. And this pencil is so inexpensive. I think for like two, it's like $2 and change. So very inexpensive. So sometimes just kind of rethink the things that you need for your makeup look. You don't always need the most expensive things. Like what's coming to mind right now is Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade that everyone's loving. I have that and it's sitting over there with the rest of my makeup and I don't ever use it. But this I like. Okay, lastly, this is the mascara that I always use, and you guys will always see me using this because it's very inexpensive and I think it works great. And this is the CoverGirl Great Lash Mascara in Black is Black. And then on my nails, I have this polish which I don't like. I love the color, but I think the polish is not, the quality of the polish is not so great because the first coat is pretty much transparent and then you have to continue to build it up to get the color you see here. But it is a Maybelline Color Show polish and the color is Deep in Violet. And I think it's just a really pretty color once you get the intensity built up with several coats. But besides the quality, the color is really, really, really pretty. I really like that. So, alright guys, that's it for this Face of the Day video. Please subscribe here to my channel if you're not already subscribed for more videos. Also, follow me on Instagram. I'm Everything Ebonee on Instagram. And also, I'm on Facebook under Everything Ebonee as well. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys again soon. Bye-bye.